Good morning. Welcome all of you in 12th lecture of linear equation in two variables. So we have completed 3.3, 3.4, 3.5 and we started 3.6. Already we completed one question. Now in this exercise we are first change the equation into linear equation in two variables. Again I am repeating, the standard form of linear equation two variable is ax plus by plus c equal to 0, means x and y should be in numerator. Again you can see here that x and y are in denominator. So to change these two equation into linear equation, we left 1 upon root x equal to a and 1 upon root y equal to b. So if I leave this 1 upon root x, then 2 is extra, so this will become 2a, this will become 3b equal to 2, then this will become 4a minus 9b equal to minus 1. Now we get these two equations. Now we can apply the elimination method. So we multiply this first equation by 2 and then we will solve. We get value of b equal to 1 upon 3. We put value of b in first equation. Then we will solve and we find out the value of a. So after finding the value of a and b, we have to find out the value of x and y, because our question is in x and y, so our answer should be in x and y. So we will write this a equal to 1 upon 2, then b equal to 1 upon 3. We will replace a by 1 upon root x. We will cross multiply. We will get root x equal to 2. In the same way, value of b is 1 upon 3. We will replace b by 1 upon root y. And then we will cross multiply. We will get root y equal to 3. But we don't want this value under the root. So to remove this root, we will take this extra step. This is squaring both sides. So root x square, here 2 square, root will cancel with square, we are left with x and 2 square is 4. In the same way, squaring both sides, root y square equal to 3 square, 3 square is 9, and here this root and square will cancel each other. So you should know the first step here, that how we can change these equations into linear equation, then there will be no problem. Okay, let us study two more questions. Third and fourth part of question number first. Now you can see this is the third part. So 4 upon x plus 3y equal to 14, 3x minus 4y equal to 23. Here only x is present in denominator, not y. So we will consider 1 upon x equal to a. Here no need to take 1 upon y as b, because y is already present in numerator. So we will take only 1 upon x equal to a. So this equation will become 4a, 3y as it is, 14 as it is. This equation will change into 3a minus 4y and 23 as it is. Now we will apply the elimination method. By applying elimination method, we will get y equal to minus 2. So here we find out the first answer. Then we put this value of y equal to minus 2 in first equation and we will solve. We will get the value of a. But we want answer in x and y. Y already we get. So we will change the a into 1 upon x. So 1 upon x, 5 we can write, 5 upon 1. Then we will cross multiply and we will get answer x equal to 1 upon 5. So in first three part, we can take 1 upon x or 1 upon y or 1 upon root x, 1 upon root y as a and b. It depends upon the question. Now fourth part. Here we will check that in denominator x minus 1, here also x minus 1. Then in second value y minus 2, here is also y minus 2. So here we will take 1 upon x minus 1 equal to a. This first value is common here, x minus 1. So we will take 1 upon x minus 1 equal to a. Then 1 upon y minus b equal, 1 upon y minus 2 equal to b. So this equation will change into 5a plus b equal to 2. This equation will change into 6a minus 3b equal to 1. Now we are having these two equations. So here extra point is only this, that it is not necessary that always in denominator we are having x. We can have some number with x or y also. Like here we are having x minus 1 then y minus 2. So we will solve these two equations by elimination method. We will get value of a equal to 3, b equal to 1 upon 3. By chance both value are same. So elimination method, you know it very well, so you can solve a and b no problem. Now we will write a equal to 1 upon 3, b equal to 1 upon 3. We will replace a by 1 upon x minus 1. Then we will cross multiply x minus 1 into 1, x minus 1, 3 into 1, 3. This minus will become plus on this side. So first answer is x equal to 4. In the same way, we will cross multiply y minus 2 into 1, y minus 2, 3 into 1, 3. This minus 2 will become plus 2. So 3 plus 2 equal to 5. So in this way, first step is we can change the equation into linear, equation into variable, and then we can find out the value of a and b. And at last, we have to change a and b again in x and y. So tomorrow we will study its fifth and sixth part.